Clarifications and conventions. When we say a body is in equilibrium, the summation of forces along the x is zero. Summation along the y is zero. And summation of moments on any point is zero. We also take positive values for upward and to the right directions. Negative values for the directions going to the left and downwards. We also take positive values with motions at clockwise and negative for anti-clockwise or counterclockwise. In the case of pins or hinges, we have two components. And only one component or reaction with rollers, which is perpendicular to the surface. For the assumptions, if we have assumed the value or the force going to the right and we have a positive result, the actual force is going to the right. But if we have a negative result, the actual force is going to the left. Same goes with the assumptions on tensions and compressions. The forces in the various members of a truss can be determined by the method of joints. The notion that all members of a truss are two force members carrying actual loads means that the free body diagram of any point is a concurrent force system in equilibrium. Since for a concurrent system, only two independent equations can be written. One must start with joint acted only by two members.
This is our first example in solving analysis of structures using methods of joint. In this problem, we have to determine the forces acting on members AC and AB. We have BC 100 pounds tension. Component method. two equation, we will get AB 100 pounds tension. Next is at joint A. We will get 86.6 pounds tension.
The principles of equilibrium of non-concurrent force systems may also be applied to truss analysis. The procedure is known as the method of sections. Its use permits us to determine directly the force in almost any member instead of proceeding to that member by a joint-to-joint analysis. This method is usually preferred to the method of joints when the force in only one member or very few members of a truss is desired. In this method, a cutting plane is passed through the entire truss, separating it into two parts without cutting more than the three members.
Now we have an example of a problem that we will solve using the method of sections. At this diagram, we are tasked to determine the forces along the bars BD, DE, and CD. So first, we have to identify the unknown external forces. So we have the reaction at C and F. Only one reaction because this is a both are hinged. So we would like to get the value of the reaction at C so that we will focus on this left section if we will cut through this portion of the diagram later on. So at first we will have a summation of moments with respect to point F. Let's have first the 1,200 pounds. It will be positive because it will cause a clockwise rotation in the point F. Multiply by the distance from F, so we have 6 feet. Next, the 1,200 pounds here at bar EF will be neglected because it will pass the point F. We will now consider the 1,200 pounds here, and this will cause a counterclockwise direction, so it will be negative, so minus 1,200. Multiply by the distance, 12 plus 6, 18. Next, 600 pounds, it's the same as the 1,200 pounds here, so negative. Multiply by 12 plus 6 plus 6, so 24. Next, the reaction at C, it will cause a clockwise direction, so positive.
RC. Then multiply by the distance from F, 12 plus 6, 18. Equals 0. So we can compute now for the value of reaction at C. We will get 1,600 pounds. Our next step, we will cut the diagram now into two. We are going to solve for BD, CD, and DE. I'll choose to cut here. And we will focus on the left section. After we cut here, we will assume the direction of the forces that are cut. Now, we will focus on this left side, and we will compute the summation of forces along the vertical axis. So, we have negative 600. Minus 1,200. The reaction C, which is equals to 1,600, so plus 1,600, and DE. But in this case, we have to compute the hypotenuse of the triangle that will be drawn here, because the force DE has an angle. The point D. E. So the distance here is 12 and the height is 4. Getting the hypotenuse by Pythagorean theorem, it is the square root of 10. So now add DE. Multiply by, you can have it as 1 and 3 to simplify. So, 1, the vertical distance over the hypotenuse. We can now solve for the value of DE, which is equals to 132.46 pounds. And the sense is tension, because we got a positive value assuming that the force DE is pointing away from this point D. So positive 632.46 pounds tension. Next, we will find, we have the value of DE. We will now get the value of CD. For getting the value of CD, we will solve CD at point C. And we will have the summation of moment at B. Equals 0. So we have the force course B will be neglected because it will pass the point B. So we have the DE. A while ago we have the we get the triangle formed here. So we have DE. We also have the transmissibility rule. We can extend the force DE up to here. So the value of its horizontal component will be zero, and we will be having only the value of the horizontal component of DE. So DE. Times 1 over square root of 10 multiplied by the distance from point B. So 6 plus 12 equals 18. Next, the reaction C, RC, will be also neglected because it will pass the point B. So we have the I will also assume the sense of CD or the direction of CD here and BD here. So the force BD will be neglected, and for CD we have as we see here, it has an angle. So we have first to resolve the triangle here. We have the base as 6 and the height as 8. By Pythagorean theorem, we can also write this as 3 and 4. By Pythagorean theory, we will get the hypotenuse as 5. So we have the value of extend the 4CD up to here, so that its vertical component will be 0 because it will pass through B. So we will only include its horizontal component. So negative CD times 3 over 5 multiplied by the vertical distance, which is 4 plus 8, is equal to 12. Equals to 0. And we can now solve for the value of CD, which will be equal to 500 pounds and compression. Compression because we got the positive result or value, and we assume that the force CD is pointing towards C. Next, we have to solve for BD. First, we can recognize the triangle here. With a base of 6 and height of 4. But we can simplify it as 2 and 3. By Pythagorean theorem again, the hypotenuse is square root of 13. Next, we have to, this portion, we will have the summation of forces. So we have, for BD, it's positive. BD multiplied by 2 for the vertical component, 2 instead of 30. And next is for CD, it's downward, so minus CD. And the vertical component, 4 over 5. Multiply by 4 over 5. Next, for force DE, we have, it's upward, so positive or plus DE. Multiplied by vertical component, 1 over square root of 10. We will just substitute the values of the first two forces to have the value of BD, which is equals to 360.55 pounds tension. And that's it.
If some or all the members of a pin-connected structure are subjected to bending action, the structure is called a frame. They are designed to support loads. They are analyzed by considering the separate free body diagram of each three force member, the procedure of which is called the method of members.
Determine the forces acting on the beam. So the first thing we need to do is to get the forces in each and every member. So let's get the FBD.
First, we need to calculate the moment at rad CD.
Calculate the moment at rad AB. So we need to calculate the moment along the force.
we can substitute the dy at the rad CB to the dy at rad AB.
Next example using the methods of frames or method of members. In this diagram, the problem is to determine the components of forces in B acting at AB. Now let's draw the FBD diagram. Assume that the AX is towards to the right. AY is compressed. And B is compressed while the BY is upward.
Next is the next part. After determining the FBD diagram, let's now solve for the members AB first.
Let's now first get the external forces by using moment at B. So Bx would be now equal to 120 pounds. As you can see the diagram, Ax is equal to Ax, so Ax now will be equal to 120. Now take a look at the FBD AB for you to get the summation of x. So Bx now will be equal to 120 pounds to the right.